When most of us hear Starship, we think about something from a science fiction movie or our favorite TV show. However, we live in a time where the idea of starships won't be considered as fiction for a long time anymore. It is in fact becoming a reality, and the first step has been taken. What is a starship? All the space-related travel of modern times has been interplanetary, and accomplishing interstellar travel will be a tremendous breakthrough for our species. Interstellar travels will provide answers and solutions to the future of our existence. A starship can be classified as a spacecraft designed for interstellar travel. It must be able to travel at speeds faster than light or make use of a shortcut as provided by wormholes to reach a destination far away from Earth. SpaceX are actively working on the first interplanetary ship, Starship. The pioneering generation of Starship will accomplish much less than interstellar travel. Nonetheless, it provides a foundation that is crucial to reach the ultimate goal. Initially known as Big Falcon Rocket, Elon Musk announced a name change of the craft, feeling that the name is more suited for the end goal and future versions of Starship. What is the purpose of Starship? The current intention of Starship is to aid humans in becoming a multi-planet species. In the short term, it will enable the transport of the largest payloads up to date, and further down the line, it will provide transport for a high number of people to another planet, whether it be to and from the Moon or Mars. Additionally, Starship has the ability to support Earth-to-Earth transport, which will enable long-distance trips to be completed within an hour. The main selling point of Starship is that it will be the first of its kind to be fully reusable. Reusability in this case means that Starship will be fully reusable after landing, and its booster called Super Heavy will detach from the main ship after entering low Earth orbit, re-enter the Earth's atmosphere, and successfully land on the launch mount, to be used again without any refurbishment, as well as serving the purpose to make Starship refillable. Why Starship is built from stainless steel? The large diameter of Starship is the most noticeable. This large diameter is due to a pressurized volume of 1,000 cubic meters, which can hold a cargo load of up to 150 metric tons or 100 people. At first, the main material selection of Starship seems counterintuitive, with materials such as aluminium and carbon fiber that is lighter and provides adequate strength. Stainless steel does not seem like a good choice. Due to Starship being fully reusable, it will ascend from and re-enter the Earth's atmosphere. For ascent, you want something that is strong at cryogenic temperatures due to the liquid oxygen propellant, and for entry, a scorching heat must be withstanded. This is where the high-quality stainless steel 301 alloy starts to shine. At cryogenic temperatures, the stainless steel exhibits an increase in strength, thus not having any issues of the material becoming brittle. Steel can easily operate at temperatures of around 840 degrees Celsius, whereas both aluminium and carbon fiber are unable to operate at these temperatures as required. Another benefit of the stainless steel is that heat shielding on the backside is unnecessary. The side facing the wind does, however, require a means of cooling and will be the first to feature a regenerative heat shield. This heat shield will operate by means of transpiration cooling, where a double-walled shell with either water or fuel flowing between the stainless steel layers with micro openings on the outer side of the shell provide an exit to the fluid. The heat at the windward side will then be marginally absorbed by the fuel and thus cool this side of Starship. Although stainless steel is the heavier material choice, it provides overall better properties for the extreme operating circumstances of the spacecraft, as well as being the more economic approach. We will be part of the generation that colonizes Mars, but will we stop there? Will we go beyond that and pursue interstellar travel? Let me know what you think about the future of space travel.